clay's a bit dry. I left it on these bats here a bit too long yesterday to dry out, and it's a bit stiff this. Inspired lately by a couple of people. I bought a book, a biography of Michael Casson, who was a big hero of mine. I met him in the 70s, fantastic man, and I just love his jugs. Have a go at throwing some tall sort of medieval type stuff. And then on Facebook the other day I saw some jugs by Doug Fitch, which were really nice. And we're just gonna have a go at doing some tall, simple medieval style mugs. It's a bit, this clay's a bit hard in places, you can see it. Not wanting to throw very well, but we'll give it a go. This is the first one, so don't worry if I lose it. It was almost just too dry to throw really, but I like a challenge. The clay being a bit uneven in the mixture sort of thing. Leaving quite a bit of the top here, thickness, compress it a bit. I like to have a thick rim so we can pull a good lip on it. From the bottom. Got some photos pinned up here. The skills out of the book. Still on even the top, what the hell? Thank you. getting some after now. I'm going to leave this uneven top, not because it's virtually impossible to get rid of, because it's been pulled into that kind of thickness by the clay not being that well mixed, because it dried a little bit too hard on the back. But I'm going to use the high bit as part of the lip. See if I can't utilise the mistake, or the problem I should say, that's caused by it. It's going to be a fairly tall shape, this. It's going to go in at the bottom. Just put that in. God, it's going really off centre this now, isn't it? There's some throwing ridges in it. Short handle on it, and I'll do the pulling of it in a bit, and you'll see that in a bit.